Now, I don't know much about your people, but,
What do you mean, his people?
Racist.
But, you might want some more. I mean, we have more water, and we'll fill it before we leave, so...
If it is... Okay, I only have 5 because it is that is as most as I can carry on myself with my bags. If you would like me to purchase more, I can, but I cannot carry them.
Well, we can put those on the pack animals. Or...
Pack animals. Yeah, so, like, long story short, if, like, I'll purchase as many water skins as you guys recommend him.
Okay.
It's the problem with me is just I have to carry a shit ton of, like, stuff.
Yeah.
So, if you guys give me, like, animals to put it on, I can do. What is, like, as people who are more familiar with this campaign, how many times worth of water skins do you think
I should be going for? For you, maybe, like, 15 or 16.
I mean, 20.
4 a day for you, buddy. So, we haven't traveled more than like a day out into the desert at this point. So, really, I think all you'll need is like maybe 4 to 8. But
I'll purchase up to how much gold does this water skin get?
Let's take a look.
They were less
than that. There are only 2 silver for each water skin.
Yeah.
I'll purchase like I'll go up to 20 water skins, I guess.
All right. Can you mark that? Are you giving him your spare camel or what are you guys doing?
We'll let him use camel number 4.
Okay.
If you want to name it something clever, you can.
All I've done is name the camels like Aquarius's camel.
Yeah.
So you guys can name them if you want, but
my camel is called Camilla Camillo.
Camilla Camillo.
Beautiful.
Just make sure that you put 25-pound water skins on his camel. Assuming you're filling them.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yes, I am. I'll fill them all in the little water.
Mm-hmm.
If it's fine with everyone, I need to put actually quite a bunch of stuff in the camp. So, like, my bag and stuff. That's, like, rations and torches and shit.
Alright.
Do you have access... You should have access to the camel. No, I do not. Sorry, it's Satiz. I need to give you that.
No, I do. I do. I can open it up.
Alright. Well, you can put whatever you want on the camel that's Aquarius's camel.
Cool, cool.
Butch Ender of Worlds?
You got a problem with that?
Okay. Clark, are you naming your camel? I have Clark's camel there for you.
Maybe. Someday something else. We'll see.
If it lives long enough, like if it deserves a name.
Sure.
Okay.
Where are these camels?
They are under main or misc characters. Yeah.
I'll name it Aquarius's backpack because this is all gonna be on my backpack. And if you look at my character sheet, I did it in a funny, weird way.
Okay.
I'll do it more sensibly in the future.
Sure. The day is yours. Are you guys gonna shop around for anything?
What time is it?
Early. It's before noon.
And we're all together, right?
Mm-hmm. You're in the saloon, yeah.
What do you say, guys? You think we should head down, kill some gobs, get that loot? You gotta have something down there.
Yeah, I guess. Fabio's not feeling great, but okay.
Maybe Aquarius over here can find himself the start of that aquifer he was talking about.
Yes. Do goblins know aquifers?
I wasn't meaning that as much as we're going underground and maybe you'll see something. I don't know. Maybe you'll see something.
I agree. I will look out.
Well, suppose I owe you guys the idea of finding loot, so sure. We can go out there again and dig deeper. I like the idea of digging deeper.
Okay.
On the travel, I look strangely at both camels and alpacas because this is fucking weird.
You have two alpaca with you, right? Should be four camels, yes.
Two alpaca.
Okay. Yes, I've already rolled their HP in case of random encounters.
I shall defend the alpaca with my life.
Okay, so on the map screen, Satiz, you're leading the party. Are you heading south from Newwater? Or what do you want to do?
Going straight south. I'm going to try to pick up the feeling of how we got to that place last time. Y3 is where we want to go.
Okay, so let's take it one thing at a time. So you're going to get to the edge of the desert is the goal. And then check the weather, right? Because you're a desert ranger and you know these things.
Yeah.
Okay. Give me an intelligence check, Satiz and Fabio.
Oh, what kind of check? Sorry, that was loud.
Intelligence. Okay. Satiz, you guys are walking along the road. You've walked this path many times before. And it comes to mind that this is the same path you traveled before when you saw that weird hidden set of double locked doors into the side of like a crag. So you're just thinking about that as you pass, you're walking through the road.
That one thing was out in the desert though, right?
No, it was along this road and you guys decided to not check it out at the moment. You were bringing back that convict. Remember that fugitive?
Right, boy.
And then along the way back, you saw that, and you never followed up on it. Just letting you, your character, I just wanted to see if your character would remember.
I don't remember that thing. So, now that you mention it, it does come to mind. So I tell Clark in the party, I'm like, hey, so there's those doors that I remember telling you guys about,
Clark doesn't know anything about it. Mm-hmm. Wexford knew, and Wexford died.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's like, well, Clark, when we came around here the first time, we were looking around and we happened to see these doors, in like near this area, and I was wondering if you'd like maybe want to check it out.
You guys know anything about this the spot? Like, did you look into it at all? Or
we I believe we marked it. I vaguely remember, maybe. I remember what it looks like, I just don't remember where it is.
Well, it's near this like cliff face kind of thing, right? So
hey, don't ask me.
Did you mark it?
We never marked it, I don't think.
I
didn't mark it.
Mm-hmm.
I think Clark might have marked it. I could be wrong though.
Okay. Why don't you guys?
I mean, not Clark Wexford.
Yeah. Why don't Satiz and Fabio give me investigation checks with advantage because you've already been there before. Okay. Between the two of you, you can find that door again. It takes a while. You spend like an hour combing through the kind of the mountainous region and you're like, oh, there it is. Because it is, you know, it's hidden, but just not very well.
Alright, guess we're taking a little detour here. We found the thing. Let's get in these doors, try to pop them open, maybe.
Okay, they are locked with chains. It's like a kind of like a little padlock, and but yeah, they're wooden doors, so conceivably, if you had like an axe or something, you could probably bust your way through.
I try to use my crowbar.
Okay. Is there a precedent for
crowbar?
You have a crowbar? Nice. Awesome.
Yes, it is in my camel.
Okay.
Alright, yeah. Well, if you need that, we got it.
So you guys wanna try and work at this the chains on this thing with your crowbars?
Yeah. Would it be like an athletics check?
It says strength checks with advantage. When you're talking about giving leverage to something with a crowbar. So we'll just do strength. Okay. So you guys are working at this for a while. And eventually you'll be able to break them. I mean, there's three of you with crowbars. It's a wooden door. So at some point, like, you know, 45 minutes in, you're really working at it, giving it some elbow grease and crack.
I think if it starts going to 45 minutes, I begin to, like, just hit it.
Okay.
With, like, hit the wood rather than the chain with a crowbar and see if I can, like, go through it.
Well, yeah, you spend some time, and eventually it cracks open. By now, we're past noon. The sun is high in the sky. You've made quite a bit of noise, but nothing has, you know, come bursting forth from the door or anything like that.
You got it open.
What do you think we doing, Clock? Should we head in?
Yeah, let's head in very carefully.
So, Aquarius, you got some armor on. Looks like you can fend for yourself, at least. Would you mind maybe going in first? You look pretty pretty strong.
Yes, maybe. Yes, this is... I agree.
I got your back,
bro. Good. Good, somebody who's willing to go in first, because...
This is so funny, because, like, we're basically took this new party member to a door with chains, and we try to get him inside first.
Catch him in first.
He's just like, yeah.
Like, that's fine.
Like, sweet, so much child.
Aquarius is completely oblivious and very innocent, naive fish boy.
This is how we killed our last tank.
Say this. I'm gonna just fucking wreck face.
Yeah, dude.
Sorry.
Okay, you guys should be able to move your tokens and such. All right, so you get up to the door. What do you do, Aquarius?
Is it open after all this time?
It's like busted open at this point. Yeah.
If there are like visible holes, I'd like to first use divine sense.
Okay.
Oh, I did it privately again. Sorry. Divine sense to see if there's any like fucking scary demons inside.
Within 60 feet.
Yeah.
Let me see what that looks like.
If there's like a demon inside.
Yeah, if it's like right, if it's like right here or something, then.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay. You do not get anything within 60 feet of you.
Oh, yeah. By the way, John's told us in the past, like last session, that he doesn't have any leveling system. Like wherever we go, we could be entering a level 15 dungeon.
Yeah, fair right warning.
Now. Yeah.
Well, so it's pretty fucking weird.
No, what
I my ability and everything is fine.
Yes. So how I worded it was I didn't tune any of these things for like level 1 characters or level 2. So if it feels dangerous, you should probably leave.
Yeah,
is my assessment of that. But yes, you do not get the noxious odor of evil within 60 feet of you.
Evil is very noxious. I start walking in.
Okay, I will drag you over one so that you can actually move your character.
Ooh. Is it damp?
Yes, it is a little bit. Yeah, it's kind of dank.
I like spread my arms out and I'm like, oh.
Uh-huh. Feeling at home.
If anyone wants to go through the door,
yes,
go ahead and I'll move your token in there.
Yeah,
everything is fine. I am not dead yet.
Goes in and isn't dead yet.
Okay, so let's him. One character at a time. Who goes in next?
Go for Fabio.
I guess Fabio moves.
Okay. Is it dark? Or, like, can we
it
see?
Is dark. You're going to need torches or something to enter in further. I mean, the people who have infra vision or dark vision will be able to see because of the door. But if you don't have that, you'll need something.
How the hell do you get in here?
I can move you in.
I'm blocking. I'll say I cannot see in dark for some reason.
I got dark vision.
Oh, yes, I can. I'm a fucking liar. Can I? I forgot.
I probably might be able to see in the dark. I'm sure that you can because you live in the depths of the ocean.
That would make sense, wouldn't it? I'll check real quick. I didn't put in my character sheet for whatever reason. But yeah. I am probably able to see in the dark.
I can see that far.
Okay.
I think my dark vision's 120. I'll double check though.
Okay. Well, then, you know.
Well, I'm blind as a bat, so.
Mine's dark 60.
I suppose bats would have dark vision.
They have blind sight, which is OP. Anyways, everything's fine.
Next campaign's vampires.
If you don't draw torches, then you can see whatever you can see right now.
I do not have dark vision, so I'll ask someone to light a torch, because I have a shield. So.
Yep. Fabio, why don't you do that thing you kept doing the other day?
Huh? Yeah. All right. Guess I try and toss a rock in this direction.
Well, you don't gotta throw them.
It'd be better
to stay quiet. You just hold on to it, you know?
So you're making a light stone is what you're doing?
Yeah.
God, he just like naturally throws them again every time.
They make the smallest. Okay.
So he fucking throws it.
And the light spell is 40 dim, 20 bright? Is that what light is?
Let me check. I thought it was like 20/20.
I suggest that you just cast it on my trident or something. This is too much tryharding.
Yeah, that works too.
That's smart.
It's smart. I just poke your trident. Little boop.
Ah, you carried the magics.
just a parlor trick.
I enjoy parlors. So, can we just like move forward?
Yes, we're not in initiative yet, so you can kind of move around if you'd like.
Yeah. So
is this like a drop?
It's just like a small drop, like a couple, like a foot or something.
I tap those like squares with my trident to see if death befalls upon it.
I start
to look around for traps.
I mean, if you're just like smacking it with your trident, you don't feel like any pressure plate or something. But
fucking step straight.
It's like I don't go down. I like actually start like looking for traps.
Okay, do you want to make me some sort of trap check?
Yeah, I come to the center, towards the center, and they get investigation.
I don't remember which one is it. Is it investigation or is it perception for traps?
Sort of both, I think. It depends on what you're trying to do. I think, like, if you're trying to spot traps, I think you can spot traps passively with passive perception.
Mm-hmm.
But if you, like, actively look for them, I think it's investigation. I don't know.
I'm, like, attempting to look specifically for traps. So I guess investigation is if you pull that.
Sure.
Okay.
That sounds good. Okay, you do not find any traps.
Okay.
So, what are these things that we can see? They look like books, staves.
Yeah, you're seeing. It's you're like walking in. I don't know how familiar you are, Aquarius, with these sorts of things, but to everyone else, I suppose it looks something like maybe an alchemy lab or something. There's books around. There's beakers and. Sheet here.
If it is an alchemy lab, I am very familiar, as I am proficient with herbalism.
Really? Okay. Correct. Okay. So yes, it's clearly some sort of research lab then. You can see test tubes filled with liquids, disheveled papers scrawled in some form of writing, old blood stains resting upon the table filled with cut marks, and all manner of strange alchemical objects and tools. Hanging from the ceiling are several ceiling candles that are currently unlit, though you're kind of like looking around and do you have a strong sense of smell or no?
No, definitely okay. Not. For me to smell anything like a human, I have to like open my mouth entirely. So like, yeah, it's not a thing.
Well, you just say you're mouth breather, so.
Yeah. It's established.
With your, that light cast on your trident, you're able to see that this place forks to the left, to the right, and then also continues forward with another door wrapped in chains, similar to the one you broke open.
So, gentle friends, I believe this is a laboratory. It is in disuse, but it was locked up, so I don't know how I feel about breaking into people's houses.
How recently used is it?
Do you want to, like, investigate? Right now, you haven't done much of that.
Yep.
Okay.
Once I find it.
Okay. It looks very recently used to you. You're like, I don't know what you find. But you find something, you know, like a stain or like a spilled drink or something, and you're like, okay, this is probably, let's look at the date. The date is the 27th. It's been in use within the last couple of weeks, you would guess.
Well, can I do some sort of roll with my herbalism tool, kit proficiency? Maybe like an intelligence-based herbalism kit to see if like I know what the purpose of this place is. Like, I know it's like alchemy, but is it like, here I produce healing potions?
Yeah, Xanathar's has something that expands on what you can do with these sorts of proficiencies.
Yes. Yes, child. Give me things to do.
Herbalist. So it says an herbalist arcana check can add insight to your magical studies that deal with plants and your attempts to identify potions. Is that pretty close to what you're trying to do? Like figure out?
Yeah, yeah. I look at like those vials and see if I can identify what liquids are inside of them.
Okay. So yeah, just you can add your.
I did.
Okay.
Nice too.
You have no idea. No, you've never seen anything like this viscous fluid before as you're kind of looking through some of them.
Gentlemen, this is not water.
that's great. Hey, what about some of these books over here? And I start looking at this book above me and I start trying to read it.
Do you read Elvish?
I do.
Okay. Then what was that?
Yeah, I do.
The book in front of you here is written in Elvish. It's written in, common Elvish, not like any old dialect. And the cover says, transmutation and natural philosophy, useful properties and how to amplify them by Beshwick the Transmuter.
All right, I pick it up and I start... scrolling through the pages and stuff, just kind of skimming some things.
Okay. I mean, it's a heavy topic, so you're going to have to either, like, read through it or, like, skim through it, but it's going to take you some time to really understand it. You know what I mean? So,
transmutation spells. I'll just speak up and say, oh, looks like this guy was dealing with some transmutation. I know that.
Seems like he hasn't been gone very long. Or is still somewhere around here, just hasn't been in this room.
Give me perception checks, all of you.
If,
Voodoo.
Oh, boy.
Oh, Jesus. Perception.
Oh, my God.
Cool.
Carry on.
Carry on.
99.
Hey, what's that? What's this over here? It's like a map.
Which of those three books are you looking at?
The one in the center.
Okay. You do not read this language. It's written in some strange dialect. Give me a history check, just in general, Fabio. I want to see how much of it you might understand.
I do have comprehend languages.
Well, oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, what does that do?
Nice.
Wait, can I just look at it first?
Sure. Fabio's poking around.
Okay, so you want to do comprehend languages. You're like trying to look at this book, and then the weird fish man takes it from your hands and looks at it.
Is it dwarf? And or
is not? No, it's not dwarven.
Yes. Which is John, very interesting.
I grabbed that book, by the way. Can I stash that book that I was holding?
Sure. Add transmutation book to your character sheet.
Negligible weight or how much?
No, it's not negligible. It's going to be 5 pounds. Books are heavy.
Okay. All right, that's all I wanted to do.
So do you want to cast comprehend languages?
Yeah, Fabio likes to snoop, baby.
Hey.
Okay, well then, there's nothing here that says that you know what language it is, just that you can understand it.
You can touch it and you can decipher any written language.
Yeah, like,
yeah, but it doesn't tell him, like, this is old crab man speak.
Oh, yeah.
Understand.
This is crab people.
I would speak crab people, so I'm sure I would be able to, yeah.
Right.
Crab people.
Okay, so let's look at the book. The title on the book says, The Dangers of Our New World by Scribe Wickthrondis.
Oh, God, ooh, it's one of those conspiracy nuts.
Spoopy.
I guess I kind of flip through the pages and see if I can make out anything that would be useful.
You're like looking through the pages and there
drawings of chemtrails and
no, there's like there are drawings. There's drawings of a lot of strange creatures. And if you're just like paging through it, you can quickly ascertain its purpose. This is like a bestiary for the desert, it looks like. Like the weird creatures found in the desert.
That sounds really good to have.
It's like Wacky Willy's crazy bestiary.
At some point, I speak out loud. Have you gentlemen heard of the story of the goldfish and the three bears? Where the goldfish goes into the pond and eats the soup that is not quite watery enough, and the one that is perfectly watery, and the one that is too watery? I feel like we might be in this sort of situation.
Never heard of that one.
It sounds familiar, but I don't know.
I think I heard a different version.
And how would such a story pertain to our situation?
Well, I heard one that's like that, but with goblins.
At the end of this story, three bears come in and eat the goldfish. And I feel like maybe we might be getting eaten by bears soon. Which is fine with me if it's fine with you, but...
All right. I guess I deem the book at least as useful, and I take it with me.
Okay.
I tell the rest of the party, like, hey, here's all the crazy shit in the desert.
Hey, Aquarius, okay. You getting kind of spooked here? You trying to get out of Dodge?
Well, it is not so much. I feel like we have broken into someone's house.
Mm-hmm. That's a good idea. Maybe we should be getting out of here.
It is probably not a good thing to do.
Well, let's
so
see
you're
what
taking
we can...
that book, right? By the way,
yeah,
Fabio.
Yeah.
Okay, you can add like bestiary book or something for now.
Well,
You're not going to be able to read it unless you have comprehend languages going. So, just so you know.
Yeah, I gotta Fabio's always good.
So he starts kind of taking initiative, and he starts heading into the farther part of the... starts going north.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. I'll follow whoever, like, goes out of their way.
Yeah, please.
What the hell is this stuff?
Yeah, you see some weird-ass experimental life up in the far corner there.
Is that a squid?
Something.
Well.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, this really reminds me of the goldfish.
Well, I assume that whoever's here wants to be hidden, and they're performing some sort of experience.
Yeah, I get kind of spooked.
Fabio, do you do that?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, so you're going to pocket both of the books. You don't look at them, you're just grabbing them real quick.
Yeah.
Just kind of like swipe everything off the table.
I'm just like, rah, in my backpack.
So that's 15 pounds worth of books, just so you know.
Oh, shit. Fuck.
I pick up this book by the bed and start reading, flipping
through. Give me another perception check.
Oh,
no. You approach that door.
We fucked up. Oh.
All right. As you approach the door, you hear to you, it appears very loud and audible. You can hear some strange noise coming from the other side of the door.
Guys.
And then something hits the door a little bit. And,
God.
Yeah. It was a chain door, right?
It is a chain set of double wooden doors, yes.
Kind of quietly, I say, guys, there's, seems to be something on the other side of this door.
Was there something that you wanted to do over there, Satiz, as this is going on?
Yeah, I didn't hear him talking yet, because I'm like, you know.
He's whispering, right?
Yeah, so I'm not saying it very loud.
I'm looking over at them, but I'm also, glancing at this book, and I pick it up, and I start scrolling through it.
Okay. Again, it's an Elvish, but you speak Elvish. And it's more boring wizard stuff or something. It's called, like, Semantic Conversations on Somatic Components by Rex Estrithi. All
right. I pocket it.
Okay.
It's a bunch of book thieves.
It's friends, another 5-pound book.
Are you sure we should be stealing from,
Semantics book?
Hey guys, I think there's I think there's someone doing experiments in here that probably definitely growing on the other side of this door. Whatever it is that's locked in there.
What do you mean experiments?
Well, did you see those things over there that Satis was looking at? Whatever the hell's living things over.
I didn't know he's looking at the funny pictures in the books. Thought I heard something, but whatever.
Jesus.
Definitely a wizard, whoever he is.
Well, I'm not sure what to...
Well, all you guys are getting freaked out. It's giving me a weird vibe.
Well, Fabio, if you want to go ahead and pop over to that door and you tell me what you see in there, and we'll stand over this way.
Are we getting paid for this? Is this a job?
We might. You don't know.
I tell him, no, this isn't a job. And I say, Clark, did you see something? What's going on?
I definitely, I didn't see anything, but definitely heard something on the other side of that door over there.
You did? All right.
Mm-hmm.
This isn't, I don't know about this, guys. Shit.
If you guys are like talking near the door, you can all start hearing the noises pick up from the other side. You're clearly agitating them or whatever it is.
Is it like footsteps or is it like growling and animalistic?
Give me a perception check.
Yeah, I kind of want to start investigating the sounds, so can I do that too?
It sounds... You're not familiar with the creatures on land, but it doesn't sound like footsteps to you.
Is there...
Fabio, you... 25, but you're like way back there. Fabio, it sounds like wings beating to you.
Yes. Bats and boys, bats and boys.
Just add to the list of things Fabio's scared shitless of.
Like a lot of beaten wings. I don't fucks with it. If it flies, I cries.
I agree with Fabio.
Yeah, I...
yeah, I don't know, guys. Cries.
Yeah, we don't really know what we're dealing with, so... Sounds like unanimously we're getting out of here. Let's go deal with those goblins.
How about, on the way out, one of you grabs this weird staff thing. That looks shiny.
He's pointing to his pants, by the way.
What weird staff thing? I'm gonna head over there.
Over here.
You activate the trap card.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Where at over here?
There is a staff on the table, yes.
I mean, it looks like it could get a pretty penny. Ooh, this book has a picture in it. What's the picture of?
I mean, does said staff look like it could fetch a pretty penny?
It looks quite ornate, yes. I guess I can expand what the image is.
I go to the other table and I start looking around myself at these things.
It's huge.
Wow, that thing's cool.
You wanted to look at the book, Fabio?
Nope. Yeah, it's over here. These items.
Okay, you still have comprehend languages going on, right?
Yeah, for an hour.
Then, the cover. You like look at, like, flip the cover over, look at it. It says "The Entombment of King Andrari's Miaxalim Kiridai" by Scribe Qualmeg.
You see, he has comprehend languages. So what the fuck does that mean?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
I kind of flip through the pages and see if I can figure out what the fuck that title even means.
Total understanding.
It is, I mean, you're going to have to read the book to really understand it, but like if you flip through it, you'll, I mean, there's like pictures of a large pyramid and stuff. So.
Okay. Just some real conspiracy shit over here, guys.
The frog's gay.
Congratulations.
Destroy the people. Corrupt the child.
I'm gonna go ahead and take a look around with a little thing I like to call Eldritch Sight. And,
hey, Clark.
Text of magic.
Clark, do you know what the fuck this is? And I tell him the title.
You have comprehend languages going. See, if you understand what entombment is, then you understand what entombment is, even if it's written in a different language.
Yeah, I was just asking if you knew anything about King Chucklenuts or whatever his name was.
Should I make?
Do you know anything about the tomb of King Andromiak? Fuck! I'll just write it down for you. I can't
fucking
say. Do you
know anything about King Andry? Andy? King Andy?
Should I make like a history check, or you just can tell me I don't?
Go ahead. I will never say you can't try.
But I
you do not.
But I can't.
Yeah, you can't succeed. It's very different.
Yeah, exactly. No idea. No idea. But I'm going to go through with the checking the room out. It's a little thing I like to call detect magic.
Okay. What are you looking at right now as you cast it?
Well, I'm going to start off looking in the direction of Mr. Fabio and the staff here.
Okay, the staff. Let me look. Fabio does have magic on him.
Is it a book? Is it one of the books that he stole?
No, it is that that fanny pack he has around his waist.
It's my Peppa pick.
Yeah.
The fanny pack full of spices.
Um, You see a weak magical glow coming from that wand thing.
Okay, I was going to say, weak magical glow from right around Fabio's waist.
You know what that's about, baby.
Actually, yes, it is a weak magical glow coming from his waist.
But you said that wand or the staff?
They're both weak magical glow. Yep. And one from your weapon as well, you would know is magical.
Right, that's right.
I don't remember what the strength of that was, because we made it up.
Probably not very strong.
It is...
It's over 9,000.
No, I think it's probably like a...
1,000.
It's a moderate glow.
Okay.
It's decent.
4,500.
And you're just kind of like looking around.
Jim.
Yep.
You see Fabio's guitar is magical. That he seems to play awfully every night. He just doesn't, he can't do it. Doesn't have the skill to play it, apparently.
I know, stupid ass perception check. Should have been my other role.
Duly noted. Yeah, and then I'm going to continue to kind of glance around the room to see if
there's anything. It was a very dim glow coming from his guitar.
Is his guitar the guitar of bad noises or something? Just like always produces horrible sounds.
The guitar, you fucked up.
Everybody knows it's the player, not the instrument.
You see a weak glow coming from what looks to you like a small bag in Fabio's pants.
So he sees a wand-shaped magical glow and then a bag-shaped magical
glow. Yeah, yes.
Okay. I can imagine it. So, GM, correct me if I'm wrong, but like detect magic, it says he can sense the presence of magic. Does that mean that even if he can't like see it, he can sense that it's there, although he can't see like the aura and the type and all that stuff?
Like, I don't necessarily have to be able to see it with my eyes to be able to see.
Yeah. It says at the end, like, blocked by 1 foot of sun. And I feel like if it was just sight, that shouldn't be there. So I suggest you, like, get close to the door.
So, yes, I would say that in general, if it's like magic within 30 feet, he just knows magic is there. But the way I interpret it is, he's gonna have to like kind of go and take a closer look to really understand what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Take
a closer look at this magic wand.
You detect all magic in 30 feet of you.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's it so far.
Okay.
Is there Well, this is all happening. I just kind of idly like try and read the first page or two. Does it give me any more information of this book?
Just like reading the first page or two?
Yeah.
It's talking about this guy, this king. If you're just reading the first page, it starts with his life. Mm-hmm. And like it takes an unbiased approach to his building of this tomb.
Fair and balanced.
Okay.
If you read further, you might understand why I'm using that word unbiased.
Mr. GM, can I, what is this thing? Is it like a chest or is it just like a corner table?
Which one? This?
Down at the board. No.
Down there? That is a chest, yes.
Ooh. Yeah. Is it locked?
It is unlocked, yes.
Oh, shit. Fuck it. Intelligence 7. I open it.
Okay. Inside, you see what looks like a couple items of personal belongings, and you find some money.
How much money do I find?
Do you sit and count it out?
No. It's just like, is it like a hoard or is it like a little bag?
It's on the order of thousands of copper and hundreds of silver and dozens of gold.
What the fuck? I just am overwhelmed and close it. Don't even say anything.
Okay.
I don't want to steal that much money.
Yeah, you are paladin.
So the Fishman goes down for a moment, you know, down the path, comes back up.
Mm-hmm.
While you're looking around.
That bed is comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to step back this way towards the door again and get kind of close to it, but I'm going to leave like 5 to 10 feet between me and the door as I'm...
I guess you got me hooked now. I guess I keep nervous. Reading this book. So.
Okay. It's a large book, so you're to get a good grasp on it, you're going to have to spend some time reading it, but I mean, I can give you little bits here and there if you'd like.
All right.
I don't know... Does detect magic detect things like let's use an example. Would it detect a golem, right? Like, would it detect a construct or like a skeleton or?
I mean, constructs use
creatures that are they?
Use
I don't know
magic
if they're
to exist.
Yeah, but are they like innately magical? I'm not so sure about that.
I would argue if a magic user uses magic to create something, it. Is like interwoven with magic, otherwise it couldn't exist.
You can just tell us it's a Dracolich. It's okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, it's fine.
We won't judge you.
Those things are fun.
Yeah, that was a fun encounter. Yeah, something like that. And then skeletons, though, I would rule like if a golem is a skeleton is. But I don't really personally think of them as magical things.
Tis your call.
Undead in general, you mean you don't think are magical?
It seems, looking it up, it seems pretty split down the middle.
Yeah, that's what I'm imagining. That's fine. I'm going to say that you detect the presence of magic from the other side of the room. You get 4 signatures.
Fucking shit.
Alright, well, I'm going to quietly back away from the door and come back over here closer to the group and say to them, well, there's something on the other side of that door that is some sort of magical. Excuse me. Some sort of magical.
Was the magic moving?
Sounds like it was.
As you approached, they started moving a little bit. They seemed to react to your sound, you know?
Okay.
There are very little magical beasts underwater that one would not, how do you say, get fucked by.
Well, maybe if it was one, how massive, like not, well, I guess also how strong, you said faint, right?
I didn't give you.
Yeah, you didn't say how strong you are, right?
I think you have to see it, right, to get that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And yeah, like the physical
I'm just
size.
Giving you that there's 4 signatures of magic.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess, DM, with the with the divine sense, it says that creatures that are in complete cover, I cannot detect. Mm-hmm. How like if I punch a hole in the door and like stick my eye through it, would it like would that like still impede? I guess I mean we can science it, right?
Right. I mean it. You'll have to. Yeah. Some things you just have to try out. To know, you know?
Yeah, fuck it. I'll, see. I would like to attempt to puncture 3 holes into this door with my trident.
Okay. It's a thick wooden door, so you're gonna have to go at it.
I mean, I have time.
You have time. Probably.
What is there anything you'd like me to roll? Just like a strength check, much like a crowbar. I don't
if you want,
is not to break down the door.
Yeah, right. If you want, you can just do like a. I was gonna say attack rolls, but it doesn't really matter because you're just you have as much time as you want. Just keep going at it.
if I can eventually make like a hole to stick my eye through it.
Eventually you can do so, but you really aggravate the creatures on the other side. You hear them, you know.
Oh, those fucking noises are fucking.
Is that that meme noise from You Do Not Know the Way?
Eventually, yeah. You get your trident all the way through the door. It takes some time. This is not the optimal tool. But
no, it is not. It is the only tool my people are proud enough to use.
What do you guys do as he's going at this door for like an hour? Like,
I try and ignore it and just keep reading the book. I show Satis some boobies I found in one of the pictures.
I scream over to Aquarius and I'm like, you sure we should be doing that?
Huh? I mean, I cannot read the language, so.
Do I like it?
You know what? I go over, walk over to Aquarius, and I kind of stop him, and I'm like, I put my hand on his shoulder. I try not to like.
Hey, bud, it's okay.
I try not to like pat it too hard, and I'm like, hey, buddy, like. Are you going to beat this thing down? I think there's something behind it. That's what Fabio was saying.
My thought was, if I could make a hole, I could look through it, and then I could sense what is behind it and see if it's, like, undead.
And I look at him, and I'm like, genius. I'll be right here.
learned anything else from this book while he's been doing that?
Sure. You want to? If they're gonna just go at it this entire time, and you want to keep trying to read, you can learn a little bit more. It seems like this king. Let's see. The book documents, as far as you can tell so far, the long and brutal excavation and construction of a massive temple tomb, and the eventual procession leading to the king's entombment within it. So it's like going to be taking an unbiased look at his life and the grievous, grisly nature of his whatever he does.
What are the references like? Is it like, what is the styling of reference? How good of a, no, I'm just fucking right.
This is clearly a book written by the former elves who lived here within the desert. So it's probably old Kiridai.
No.
So before Aquarius gets too far through the door. I can't, like, when I was looking at the door earlier, it's a door that could have been pried open. It's like just chained shut, right?
It was exactly like the door you pried open before.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So we could pry it open and peek through instead of.
I fear that if we pry it open, they will just attack us.
Well.
Does anyone have any instruments that can make a hole better than this? Don't laugh and make a hole.
I can shoot my arrow, shoot it through the door.
Is there like a keyhole we can just peek through, guys?
Yeah, can we just?
I might shoot whoever's across inside there, though. I'm not really trying to hurt anybody until I know what it is.
I agree. Perhaps we should just leave.
Yeah, for now. I mean, you can always come back.
Yeah, whatever it is in there is making me a little nervous.
Yeah, it seems like a bit of a threat.
Okay. Stop.
This little staff over here.
Jesus Christ. Okay.
Staff over here, the staff of motorbike sounds is it's a little magical.
There are motorcycle demons behind that door.
Motorcycle demons.
Yeah.
Some ghost rides.
I guess I grab this book with me and I lug it out
slowly
to the exit.
Alright.
I leave the staff alone.
You can add, you know, Book of Entombment or something for now. 5 pounds. You have 20 pounds of books on you, don't you?
Yeah, I'm lugging it out to the camel.
Oh my god.
Does
I'll leave the staff.
The wand? The staff thing?
I don't grab it.
Okay.
It might be cursed.
I don't like cursed items.
Yeah. We'll leave it there.
All right.
And head on out.
This might be the first party in the history of D&D to just, nah, we don't want the magical
item. We don't want the magic item.
It was just sitting right there, man. You can't do that shit. That's fucking terrible.
Yeah, it's just sitting there waiting.
Oh, just open this.
Do you let the other party members know that they have magical items, or do you keep that to yourself?
I mean, we'll discuss it later.
Okay.
Like, while we're Sounds traveling good. A little bit. But for right now, I just don't bother saying anything.
So you guys exit?
Yeah.
Yes, I do.
Yep. I follow queries.
Outside, there's a lich being like, what are you doing in my house?
Hey, boy.
I dumped the books I had into my camels.
All right.
Okay. Can you add just like 4 books?
Yeah.
This is like, I didn't understand exactly like where this was. Is it like in this road somewhere?
Sorry, I'm going to the map. Yeah, it's like along the road. Whoops, wrong place.
Oh, right, okay.
Yep, I'm pinging the wrong place. It's along the road over here.
Okay.
Just off.
Oh,
it's
I
off.
See it. Okay, it was behind a thing.
Yep.
I was like, surely we might be able to ask someone in the new water, which felt...
It is pretty close to town, yeah. I think this is a good place to take our first break.
Let's go.
And we'll be back in a couple of minutes, so see you on the other side.